Much like schools, streets, and sewer infrastructure, trees are essential to public health and community resilience. But when you look at cities and towns all across America, the same pattern emerges over and over again. Trees are often sparse in low-income neighborhoods and communities of color, and that's not by chance. Tree equity is about investing in areas with the greatest need first to fill gaps in the urban tree canopy so that urban communities have the infrastructure they need to thrive. You can visit the Tree Equity Score application at treeequityscore.org. This is what you'll see when you first get into the application. Shaded in green are all urban areas in the United States. Over 80% of the US population lives in these shaded areas. That's over 260 million people who can find their score for their neighborhood. To get started, type a location into the map. I'm gonna type in New Orleans, and the map will zoom us in. As you continue to zoom the map will subdivide into tree equity scores, and these are your neighborhood scores. So these bright green areas are scores of 100, where there's enough trees in these neighborhoods, and the more orange the areas are, the lower your scores. And these are the areas where you're gonna wanna get started, because these are the areas with the greatest need. You're just gonna hover over the map to find your scores. It's really that simple. All right, so let's pick an area to take a closer look in New Orleans. I'm gonna use the search bar to type in Lower Ninth Ward, which comes up first on the list. This is a neighborhood in New Orleans, and this is a neighborhood that you can see has a lot of lower tree equity scores. When you click on the different block groups, the data updates in the sidebar over to the left. This one down here, one of the lowest scores in this neighborhood, has a score of 61. Looking at the breakdown of what data goes into the score, we've got 100% people of color, 83% people in poverty. And when we take an even closer look and we turn on the satellite imagery, you can see looking along these streets, there's just not a lot of tree cover. What that means in a really hot day in the summer in New Orleans is not a lot of shade and not a lot of protection. Let's turn the tree equity score back on and try a different neighborhood over in Uptown New Orleans. So we're gonna zoom across town. So you can see immediately this is a much greener neighborhood in terms of tree equity scores, and our scores are all around 100. Let's pick this one over by Tulane University. When we look over on the sidebar, just 3% people of color, 10% people in poverty. When you look at the satellite imagery, it looks completely different. There's trees lining every single street, and you can imagine how shady it would be to walk along the streets in this neighborhood. Tree Equity Score is great because you can zoom in and look closely neighborhood by neighborhood, but you can also zoom out and look at patterns on a more global scale. If we look at the general New Orleans region, we can toggle layers in our layer list and really isolate, you know, these patterns across the city. So the first thing I'll turn on is tree canopy cover. You can see down here where we were looking at that neighborhood in Uptown, a lot of green tree canopy. You can see these whites, which are neighborhoods with gaps in tree canopy. Those are where the oranges are gonna appear in your score. So when you use a map tool like this, you can build in what we call map layers. So we can click through this list and basically change what you're seeing in the stack. So I clicked down through tree cover. Now I'm looking at people in poverty. Now I'm looking at people of color. Now I'm looking at temperature disparity, and all of these pieces, when you look at them and flip back and forth, can inform kind of the drivers geographically of what's going on in your city. The other great tool to check out are the filters. This is a really great way to isolate patterns. For example, if you want to isolate only the lower tree equity scores in the city, I can set 80 as my top score and really just isolate some of the areas on the greatest need based on a numeric criteria. You can set multiple filters at the same time. So this is a really helpful tool to make those informed decisions in your community. There's a lot of great information packed into this map just in the view as you're clicking around. But if you want to go even deeper, that's when you get into the reports up in the upper right. You can open up the reports menu, and as you click different block groups, that menu is going to update with the reports that are relevant for your area. You'll see reports for different scales. So these are summaries at the locality scale for like a city or a town, at the county scale, the congressional district scale, and at the statewide scale. We're going to open the congressional district report for this area, and you'll see a huge amount of metrics and trends that help you interpret what's happening in your community. There's a great tool built in for exploring what would happen if you increase tree equity scores across these different scales. Here we're looking at our district. So what happens if you get all the block groups in this congressional district up to 80? You can start to see the change in number of trees needed. You can see the change in all of these different benefits that the tool calculates, and that continues to get calculated even as you bring those scores all the way up to 100. Tree Equity Score puts the information directly in your hands. American Forest created Tree Equity Score as a free tool to ensure that trees get planted first in communities that need them most. If you live anywhere in urban America, you can rely on this nationally recognized tool to help make the case for investment in areas where trees can have the greatest impact.